Donna Jean Valkmer Landsberg is related to the Bridges. Jeff Bridges, Bo Bridges, and the father with the white hair in, He was in the Airplane movies? No, that was Leslie Nielsen. I'll look him up. Ah, shit. Tom is related to Ellen Gale Engler. He may be her uncle. Tom is related to Ellen Gale Engler. He may be her uncle. Donna Jean Valkmer Landsberg says she was a queen. A queen. I don't know of any country. Just a queen of Satanism, maybe. She says maybe locusts were flying around her. Richard Hanning Sr.'s girlfriend that I noticed on a calendar may have been Barbara Stanwyck. Oh, she was dead, I guess. Unless the Inquirer was incorrect. I guess that doesn't matter. scare me.
Thank you. punishment requests of all the universe and God and me for all sins.
He knows that he and his Satanists don't need me or God or anything in our universe. They ask to have matter removed from them. I have friendly requests. Friendly friend. To the power of any fit matter of friendliness.
Madam Speaker, Madam Vice President, no president has ever said those words from this podium. No president has ever said those words, and it's about time.
Biden proposed a €1.5 trillion social spending plan, pushing a vision of more government investments. Pay for it, who wants to raise taxes on corporations and rich Americans, saying it's time for them to pay their fair share. It's the third ambitious spending plan Biden has put forward since becoming president.
I'm making photos so that with just two of the 9 volt rechargeable batteries instead of 4. Because I tend to let it go and forget about it, and it's been coming out too strong.
Which addresses 4 of the biggest challenges facing American families in the entire America. First is access to good education. And this nation made 12 years of public education universal in the last century. It made us the best educated, best prepared nation in the world.
Let's bring in Thomas Gift, who is the director of the Center on U.S. Politics at University College London. So Thomas, to say Biden's spending proposals are ambitious would be somewhat of an understatement. These are far-reaching and quite historic proposals, would you say?
Absolutely. I think that Biden has surprised a lot of experts by how aggressively he's come out of the gates pushing an expanded role for the federal government. You add up the COVID relief bill, the infrastructure proposal, and now the American Families Plan, you end up with a price tag of $6 trillion. That's an astronomical figure. It won't happen, or at least all of it won't happen. Conservatives are already maligning it as fiscally irresponsible and radical. Mitt Romney said that Biden isn't going to unify America if he's only appealing to the far left. Wall Street Journal editorial board called Biden's plans cradle to grave government. So Democrats may like a lot of what Biden is proposing, but I do think that a degree of pragmatism is in order. Even with budget reconciliation, Biden really can't move any further to the left than the most moderate member of his own party in the Senate. That's just a fact. So in all likelihood, I don't think that Biden would be able to undertake such ambitious federal spending, at least not all of it. Much more likely that we'll get something that's significantly pared down.
You don't think that these are actually plans that he sees becoming a reality? They're more like a starting point for negotiations with Republicans.
Exactly. They are very much a starting point for negotiations. Biden, of course, has spent decades in the U.S. Senate, and he's not expecting a warm embrace by congressional Republicans. So this is basically the game. You come out with your best proposal, then you expect to negotiate. And I think that there is room for modest compromise, especially on an infrastructure bill. But it's going to require scaling back not only the total dollar figure, but actually offering a more reasonable definition of infrastructure. Because right now, Biden's definition of infrastructure is just so capacious that it's almost that the word loses all meaning. Only about 5% of the bill that he's proposed is actually earmarked for roads and bridges. And on the American Families Plan, I think the challenge politically will be even greater public awareness that this proposal calls for a huge expanded federal role across a lot of different areas, education, healthcare, childcare, and that it aims at a much more transformative of the American social compact. So I think there's this ideological chasm here between Democrats and Republicans that's going to be very difficult to bridge.
But how do you think the American voters will react to his plans?
That's a really interesting question. I think the short answer is we just don't know. That really remains to be seen. But I do think that we can get some indication by looking at how they responded to the COVID relief bill. And it was actually quite positive. You know, that proposal had about 70% or so approval rate, which means a lot of moderates and a lot of Republicans even tended to think that was a good idea. Now, whether that translates into these bills is something different, and whether that will have an effect on how moderate Republicans might vote in Congress is also a big question. But, you know, as we've seen in recent years, a lot of American voters have been more open, I think, to an expanded federal role and more spending. And so we might see that in the polling for these proposals as well.
Today marks 100 days for Joe Biden in office. What's your assessment on how well he has performed so far?
Well, all in all, I think that Biden has to be relatively satisfied. When he came into office, he really had these two big challenges. One was the COVID vaccine distribution. He set a target of 100 million vaccines in the first 100 days. He's more than doubled that. It's been a resounding success, I think, by most accounts. And then the second was to try to get the U.S. economy back on track. He's done that with a $1.9 trillion stimulus. And so looking back, I think Biden has to say, so far, so good. But the future may be much more difficult politically, because basically all of the things that he's done either through unilateral executive action or with no Republican support in Congress. And I don't think that that's feasible going forward. So there's going to be a lot more compromise, a lot more difficulty, I think, in store for Joe Biden.
Thomas Gift, the director of the Center on U.S. Politics at University College London. Thank you so much, Thomas, for joining us here on the news tonight. And still to come, a very small rock containing very important clues. After the break, we'll tell you what it reveals about the future.
I reaffirm all requests for torture and punishment by all people in the universe for all Satanists. Affirm, reaffirm, affirm, reaffirm, affirm, reaffirm, affirm, reaffirm, to the power of an infinite number of infinities. Satanists say they've overcome what the Bible said, that I am a delight in other things, that they've overcome those strong feelings toward me.
They say it poses a grim warning about the state of climate change and sea.
participated in an international ocean discovery program with 29 scientists from 19 nations around the world. This took place in 2019 in the Amundsen Sea.
So what's the significance of you finding this so-called drop stone?
Well, people get accustomed to seeing Antarctica as it appears on the map. It seems like a normal continent with a large area above sea level, coastlines, and so forth. But the thing is, it really is ice, and that ice can melt away when conditions get warm. Climate modelers have proved that such a thing can happen, but this green rock is one of the first pieces of tangible evidence that the ice sheet has entirely melted away in the past.
So that would have happened sometime between 2 and 5 million years ago, but what kind of climate change would it take for that to actually happen again?
Well, it's interesting you mentioned the 2 to 5 million-year period. In the geological past, quite recently, that is a time when atmospheric temperatures were as warm as they were, as they are becoming today. So it's very likely that we could experience those same conditions and return to them permanently if the temperatures of atmosphere and ocean remain as warm as they are becoming now.
So I've read that you're talking about a possible rising sea level of about between 3 to 4 meters. Do you think that we're heading that way, or are we putting the right measures in place to avoid that?
Well, indications are, particularly when we imagine this small rock, it came from mountain ranges that are well known by many as the site of the Vinson Massif, a destination for seven summit aspirants, climbers. That mountain range is surrounded by hundreds of kilometers of ice, and the ice could rapidly collapse back if the breakout of ice streams such as Thwaite Glacier and Pine Island Glacier that are being studied now continues at the pace they are going.
Christine Sidaway, professor of
she
geology
says we had
at
a,
Colorado College,
where the Arctic was completely dry 2 to 5 million years
Thank
ago. And that
Hope
temperatures then were what we're approaching now, and that if it happens
raised,
again, it will be permanent,
she
said.
In favor of the newly named EU COVID-19 certificate, but some lawmakers raised concerns that it
I thought everything went in cycles. You know, that maybe 2 to 5 million years from now, we'll develop ice in the Arctic again or something, but she said it's permanent.
The ask of the European Parliament in order to avoid discrimination.
And its sea levels could rise 3 to 4 meters.
Who've had COVID or who carry a negative PCR test to be known as an EU COVID-19 certificate,
which would
instead of a digital
flood the east coast of the United States, I know.
Proposed. But in some countries, a PCR test can set you back by more than 100 euros.
That do not have yet access to the vaccine, not because we want it or not, but simply because they are not yet sufficiently widely available for all of us. And therefore, the element of testing, which is also possible to be introduced in the certificate, needs to be accessible, easily accessible, and affordable to all of our citizens. Otherwise, the introduction of the certificate may create an element of discrimination.
The plan is to have the EU COVID-19 certificate ready by summer, but many Europeans won't be vaccinated by then. Most MEPs backed the proposal, 540 in favor, 119 against. Critics feared the documents
stop recording
could be useless and described.